Welcome back, everybody, to the Chicago Bears franchise. We've reached week four. It's time for some division football. And it's the Bears on the road in Detroit this week to take on the Lions. A big second half for the Bears in Buffalo last week. Had them at 3-0 to start the year. And it's the Detroit Lions at 1-2 to get the year going. Both teams healthy, both teams returning players from last season, where the Bears and the Lions split the series even, and the Bears didn't win the matchup during the preseason. So who's going to get the win this week? The Bears enter with the number 2 defense, and the Lions enter with the number 5 offense. It should be a good game, as for the first time this year, the Bears will receive the opening kickoff. This is Cohen from the 2 across the 20, and Cohen driving his way down to almost the 30. And we'll turn things over to Mitchell Trubisky. Great second half last week against Buffalo, got the Bears to win. And so far in the season, throwing very well, 4 touchdowns, only 1 interception. Also a bit shy of 700 yards passing. Jordan Howard, the lone back on first down. The Bears run it to the left, and Howard met by Quinn and kept to a short run. Bears go 2 receivers to the left on second down, and back to Jordan Howard they go. This time a little more breathing room as Howard finds 5 yards. Third down and 3 yards to go for the Bears. And a give to Howard once again. Howard trying to fight through the defense, and he won't get there. Fourth down, and the Bears will punt it to Matthew Stafford and this high-powered Lions offense. The Lions live and die through their passing attack, and Matthew Stafford's off to a nice start this year. Of course, the last time these teams met in the regular season, it was a very rough game for Stafford. 4 picks and a Bears victory. First down for Stafford, throwing right to Marvin Jones, and the ball jarred free as Bennett Cooper with the play. High formation on second down, a play fake for Stafford. He'll look over the middle for Jones and nearly picked off by Fuller, who had 3 picks on him last season. And we'll take a look at the Bears defense. Some changes in the front 7. With first round selection, Pierce Stevens howling back and healthy. The Bears have moved him to outside linebacker. Mark Barron moves inside. Jarrell Freeman will still see some playing time every now and then, but he won't be in the starting lineup. The Bears want all their speed on the field at linebacker as Stafford throws on third down and a diving catch from Galladay to move the chains, gain of 12. This Bears secondary will be tested today. A lot of talent from this Detroit offense. Here's Stafford throwing on first down outside to Galladay, who races down the sideline. Fuller trying to track him down and just barely gets to him at the 1. Not the start the Bears wanted on defense this week, and that was E.J. Gaines who gave up the big catch and run. From the 1-yard line, 2 tight ends, but Stafford to throw once again to Golden Tate for the touchdown. Lions just marched their way down the field. It took them 5 plays to get in the end zone. This is going to be a very tough game for this Bears defense if they can't find a way to keep these receivers covered and get some pressure on Matthew Stafford. Bears offense back out there, down by a touchdown. Of course, they were down by 15 points last week and still won the game. Here's Jordan Howard on first down, working outside. He's got some room to work with. From the Bears 30 to the Lions 32-yard line, Wilson saved the touchdown because Quinn took a pretty poor angle trying to get to Jordan Howard on that run. From the 32-yard line, Bears go play action this time around as Trubisky throws, and Adam Shaheen with the catch. Darius Slay, good hit, but Shaheen with the tough grab. That'll get the Bears down to the 16-yard line. Back to the run with Jordan Howard and nowhere to go. And a flag down on the play. This one likely going against Chicago. And indeed it will. It's holding on the offense. They're going to get Kyle Long. And the Bears backed up to the 26. Richardson in motion on second down as Trubisky steps up. Pocket collapsing. No one open. He'll take off to run. Mitch inside the 20, out of bounds at the 18, gain of 9, and a third down upcoming for the Bears. Cohen checks in as the Bears need 11, and a false start on the right side of the line. That's Kasheem Douglas, the rookie, and now a third and 16. 3 receivers to the right, 1 to the left. Trubisky looking for Collins, who had it but couldn't hold on. Oh, what a catch that would have been for the rookie, who's already made several great plays for the Bears through the first 3 games. This one may be asking for a little too much. Great coverage from Lawson, and they'll bring on TJ Cartwright. 40-yard kick from the left hash. Cartwright kicked on the way, and that kick is good. The Bears on the board with 3. And we'll turn things over to the Bears defense, who look to play a little better this possession. First and 10 for Matthew Stafford. Still no run from the Lions. There's Eric Ebron outside, and the Lions to the 33. That goes down as a gain of 8 yards for the Lions. Now a give to Theo Riddick. First run of the ball game gets them a first down, gain of 5. Theo Riddick, clearly not the focal point for the Lions offense, but he's been a very good player for them so far this season. From the shotgun, Riddick gets it once again and to the 42. That's going to bring up 3rd and inches for the Lions. Stafford under center, tight end plus a fullback, but they'll go play fake once again. Stafford to the outside, and his fullback only got 1 foot down, and the Bears will get their stop. They're backed up to the 11. This is Adam Shaheen in motion right to left. They go to Howard on first down and nowhere to run. Outside of that one big run from Howard, not much going for the Bears run game today. From the 13, 2nd and 8 for Trubisky. Blitz picked up. Trubisky flips it out to Howard, and good for maybe 4 or 5 yards. And the Bears facing 3rd down once again. Split back look. Trubisky looking left. There is Meredith. Nice tight throw from Trubisky for the first down. The Bears move the chains. Always nice to see Trubisky make a tight throw on a slant. Now looking for something a little deeper down the field. One-on-one for White and knocked away. Good coverage by Lawson. And the Bears face 2nd down. Michael Burton checks in for the Bears, and the Bears run it to his side of the field and nowhere to run. Good tackle there from Kerry Hyder Jr. The Bears once again facing 3rd and 11. Again, the Lions blitz off the edge. Good pickup from Howard. Now a 1st down for Paul Richardson. The Bears move the chains and he might not be done. Lawson, can he get there to keep him from scoring? He won't do it. Paul Richardson goes 75 yards. And the Bears with the biggest play today. O-line held up well, and apologies, that was Tariq Cohen who deserved some credit. Great job reading and picking up that blitz, but Paul Richardson with the dance moves gets away from 3 Lions. Nasty side juke there, and he reaches the end zone. Big time play there. That's why Paul Richardson was brought in. And it's nice to see him finally make that big play for the Bears. Lions back out there on offense and nowhere to go for Theo Riddick. He's put down by Eddie Goldman. It's been a bit quiet this year. Same with Trey Canada. 3rd and 13 for Stafford. He steps left. Going to try to run for the 1st down. And E.J. Gaines with the wrap up. 4th down again. And the Bears get their 2nd stop. Defense starting to settle in this ballgame. How about the offense? Can they find the end zone once again? Play fake on 1st down. Trubisky throws. There's a flag down on the play. And Shaheen with the 1st down to the 32, but this one's coming back. Holding call on the Bears, now 1st and 19. Bears go to the air once again. Shaheen 1st down, even further down the field, but another flag is down. It's already 1st and 19 from the 11, and now they'll make it even worse. Holding on Kasheem Douglas, Bears backed up to the 6-yard line. 1st and 24, Jordan Howard gets the football, and the Bears going nowhere. Good tackle there from Davis. And the Bears now backed up to the 4. The Bears made the mistake of throwing backed up this far last week. This time running with Jordan Howard and a free 15 yards. Thank you, Quinn. And that would take the Bears to the 33, now facing 2nd and 3 from the 40. Trubisky looking for someone open downfield. No one there. And on 2nd down, forced to run right and throw it away. They face 3rd down once again. Trubisky from the shotgun, blitz on the way. There's Paul Richardson once again. He's got space to run. Here we go again. Paul Richardson, 60 yards for his 2nd touchdown of the ball game. What are the Lions doing on defense? Bears up by 10 points now. They have gone 17 unanswered, and we saw 25 unanswered from the Bears last week. This is 2nd down for Stafford with plenty of time as he throws down the field, and Marvin Jones splits the defense and he will take it 79 yards for the touchdown. This score just doesn't make sense. The Bears playing 2 safeties deep up top and man coverage underneath. Fuller doing what he can, thinking he had safety help up top, but Bennett Cooper and Adrian Amos a little slow to react to that throw. And Marvin Jones with the burst to break away from the Bears defense. And we're back to a 3-point ball game. Almost halfway through the 2nd quarter, Mitchell Trubisky throws left in. Cameron Meredith with the grab. Not seeing a lot of targets, but still another catch for him this season. Bears from the 49. Trubisky steps up and looking for someone, anyone open. And everyone covered. He's sacked by Spence and Star Latulale. Bears work this back down to 3rd and 8 from the 47 as Trubisky throws, and Shaheen finally gets credit for a catch. No flag this time around. 1st down, Chicago. Another split look for the Bears from the shotgun. This time Bowman checks in. And a screen left to the rookie. Bowman with the first down and almost broke that one. Free gain of 15 yards. Bears down to the 16. And looking for some more points here. Split back look again. Trubisky off mark for maybe Cameron Merritt if they're not too sure. Bears gain a couple on second down. Now facing third and eight from the 13. They could get a first down at the 5. Trubisky throws to Shaheen and wrapped up a couple yards short. And they'll just settle for a field goal. 6-point lead for the Bears now inside the final 2 minutes. Matthew Stafford and flips out to Theoretic and a little too far. And the Lions facing third down a play later. Minute 47 to go. Play fake for Stafford. Corner to Ebron. And they can't get the first. Ran the route a little too short. Fourth down Lions. And here comes Chicago. A little over a minute left, and the Bears with three timeouts. Can they find a way to get something here on the board? Trubisky taken down, and is Kerry Hyder getting past Kasheem Douglas? Third and 14 now for the Bears. Minute 7 left in the first half. Bears go screen to Richardson, and this time the Lions actually get to him. That could have been dangerous once again, but this ball will go back to the Lions. A little under a minute left. Matthew Stafford, 7 for 12, 180 through the air, plus two scores. The Bears very well know the Lions will be passing here, and they've got to get a stop here. Pressure coming in, and Stafford taken down. Akeem Hicks was unblocked. They get it back down to a third and one, and it's Stafford once again taking a big hit from Eddie Goldman, and the Bears will close out the first half strong on defense. Second half should be a good one coming up next. Welcome back to Ford Field for the second half of this divisional matchup in the NFC. Bears lead by 6 and Amir Abdullah on the return. Abdullah ripped down by Quentin Demps at the 20. And out comes the Lions offense. They look to keep this pass game going, but they've got to find a way to mix things up. And they go to the run on first down. This is Theo Riddick to the outside and met by the defense. But after 14 yards, we're giving up. Riddick 8 carries, 41 yards. Now a three tight end look for the Lions. Bears bring pressure. Quick throw to Ebron. Big time first down once again for the Lions. And Stafford 219 on 9 completions. The Bears secondary getting torched so far this ball game. Now Stafford outside to Galladay, who almost broke that one up the sideline again. Kept to a first down catch from the 31. Riddick once again met by Henry Wong. And kept to a shorter run this time around. Unfortunately, that's the first tackle for Wong today. Third and 15 for Detroit. Bears need to stop here as Stafford has plenty of time. Throws left to Riddick, and he's met by Humphrey and Gaines. Fourth down, Detroit, they will take the field goal. On comes fellow rookie kicker Carter Trueblood from 46 yards. This one from the left hash, and that kick is good. And we're back down to a 3-point game. Bears offense back out there looking for some more plays, and they'll get this going with Jordan Howard. Nice little run there for 3. The second half is normally when the run game takes over for Chicago. Back to Jordan Howard on second down. Nice run outside and cuts it back upfield for an 8-yard gain. And the Bears now facing a 3rd and 1 from the gun. Howard gets the football. First down Bears. They won't be stopped this time. 14 carries, 85 yards, a 6-yard average for Jordan Howard. Again, a lot of that coming on that first run. Trubisky, second down, quick throw with the pressure coming off the edge. And Cameron Meredith with the grab. Hasn't been the most impactful start for him. That's only his 10th grab this season. Bears from the 40, Trubisky, and the old line is absolutely demolished and pushed back as Trubisky is sacked again. That time the Bears lose 6, now a 3rd and 16. This is Kevin White in motion. Trubisky trying to step up and taken down again. Ansa gets past Vollmer, and the Bears are forced to punt the ball away. Lions with a chance to take the lead now, down by 3 points. Late in the third quarter, 3:43 to go. They go back to Theo Riddick, and another nice run there, good for 5 yards. 3rd and 4 for Stafford from the shotgun. He looks outside to Ebron once again. Bears leave the flats uncovered, but Ebron still ran the route short, and no first down for the Lions. Bears defense catching a break once again. Now Trubisky first down looking for Deion Sims, and a little off the mark there. Got to make that throw. Trubisky a little off the mark as a whole this ball game, only 13 of 20. And the Bears go to Jordan Howard on second down. That's good for 6 or 7. And the Bears get this down to another manageable third down. Pretty safe to say the Bears will throw for it here on third down. Five receivers, no one open. Trubisky will take off and move the chains, gain of 6 yards. Maybe the last play of the third quarter here, 28 seconds. Bowman checking in again for Chicago as Trubisky looking for Collins down the seam, and he was pretty much tackled. Still no catch so far for the rookie. Chicago from the 46-yard line, a play fake for Jordan Howard. Trubisky looking under pressure and picked off by Jones. And this will be taken back to the Bears' 48-yard line. Vollmer giving up pressure once again. Trubisky not looking to be sacked this time around. And he thought he had his man. Looking for Meredith on the deep in route. Jones looked like he was going to go to the flat to cover Shaheen. And ended up jumping that throw instead. So the Lions with a short field here. First and 10 from the 38. Wong almost got a sack there. But off in time is Stafford to Theo Riddick again. 15 of 20. Almost 300 yards passing. Chicago getting almost no pressure. Now with second and 6, this is Ebron, first down Lions to the 26-yard line. Stafford finding all kinds of time to throw. The Bears have got to get some pressure on him to end this ball game. It is Stafford looking for Galladay, and he ran into his own man. And the Bears catch a break there on second down. A third and 8 coming up for the Lions from the 24 now. And it's Stafford again, clean pocket, throws to Ebron again, another first down for the Lions. There are just too many people to account for. Inside the 15-yard line now, the Lions go to the run, and Mark Barron there to make the hit on Riddick. And that's a loss of 3 to back them up to the 15. Second down, Stafford looking to throw this time around, flipped out to Abdullah with pressure coming off the edge and nowhere to go. Good coverage there from Barron. Third and 15 now for the Lions. Stafford under pressure out the gate. He's brought down by Henry Wong. And the Bears dial up a perfect blitz on third and 15. You cannot give them time to make a 15-yard throw. It's either you take the check down or you take the sack. That sack, however, would not take the Lions out of field goal range. So a tie ball game here in the fourth quarter. The Bears are kind of falling apart on offense. They have not done much. 20 points from the first half, but since then, not much offense from Chicago. Bears trying to go screen to Cohen. That's well covered, and Howard can't find anything. And the Bears actually end up losing a yard at that time. Bears backed up 10 yards after a holding call, so second and 21 for Chicago. Trubisky looking, and no one open in time as Hyder comes in untouched in his third sack of the ball game. Bears backed up at the 2-yard line. The Lions will stack the box, and the Bears just run it right with Cohen. Just trying to buy O'Donnell some space to get the ball away and send it back to the Lions. And that's exactly what they'll do. Detroit with a pretty decent starting field position from the 44. But the run game here is not going anywhere. That's Eddie Goldman with the stop. And now Theo Riddick is shaking up for the Lions. Holding his hip, and that is not a good sign for them. As Amir Abdullah will have to check in for the Lions on 3rd and 12. Bears need to stop here once again. They'll bring heat with Barron off to the left, and Abdullah can't find the first down. Another great blitz call from Chicago. And Cooper with the quick wrap-up. Bears defense doing all they can at this point to keep this ball game tied. Trubisky on first down from the 31, offline for Meredith. Maybe better off running the football there to get the first down. Trubisky throwing again on second and 10. Quick throw to Adam Shaheen. Good for maybe 5 yards, and that's Shaheen's fifth reception, not including the ones called back for penalties. Big third down here for the Bears, looking to move the chains, but Trubisky missing Collins. And the ball will go back to the Lions, and we're inside the final 3 minutes. This is when the Bears defense can't break down. They've got to keep their pressure up on Stafford, and a quick screen to Golden Tate's not going much of anywhere. Third and 5 from the 22. This is Riddick on the carry, working to the left. Then they go with the run. It fools the defense. They move the chains. And that'll take this down to the 2-minute warning. They still have 3 timeouts to work with, now going empty. Stafford quick throw to Ebron. And nice tackle there from Pierce Stevens Howling. That'll keep that gain at 5 yards. Now 2nd and 5 for the Lions from the 41. Stafford quick check down to Riddick. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1 from the 44. Clock down to the final minute 30. And it's Stafford under pressure. Mark Barron got through the defense. And down goes Matthew Stafford. If Riddick had blocked instead of immediately releasing, Stafford maybe had someone open, but didn't have the time. So the Bears with a minute 7 to go. Trubisky trying to put this game away. He'll take off and slide here at the 44, and the Bears letting this clock keep running. Down to 41 seconds now. Trubisky play action, looking downfield. Got Kevin White. Kevin White gets a block from Meredith, and the Bears are in field goal range. And the Lions call a timeout. This play called maybe too good. Collins carries the middle linebacker up the field. Look at that space in the zone. Great play call. Now the Bears can settle for three and win the ball game with the rookie TJ Cartwright. 33 seconds to go from the 21. Bears go with the run. Howard runs through Quinn. They don't want the field goal. Howard wants a touchdown. This Lions crowd is shocked. What a run from Jordan Howard. Offensive line did a great job up front, and Howard and Quinn meet at the point of contact, and Quinn did not want anything to do with Howard on that run. Next time, just move out of the way. That's the first points for the Bears since the final minute of the second quarter. Now the Lions looking to respond. 75 yards to go, 28 seconds on the clock, and two timeouts. This is Stafford over the middle to Galladay, and not much of anything on that completion, only good for seven. And the Lions call their second timeout. Stafford again looks to throw, this time a deeper throw to Galladay. That'll get them to the 43. 18 seconds on the clock, first and 10. And no timeouts left for the Lions. Got to find the end zone. This is Stafford floating one down the field. Then it's intercepted by Kyle Fuller. The Bears are going to win this game as well. 4-0 to start the year. This throw from Stafford, I'm not sure what happened here, but this was not pretty. I mean, you've got three receivers, and pretty much you gave none of them a chance to catch the football there. That was very underthrown, and the Bears will just run out the rest of the clock with no timeouts left for the Lions and win this ball game 27-20. Offense finds a way to get points late, but shout out to the defense once again for holding things down while the offense was trying to put things together. Literally couldn't have won this game without them. Of course, the defense had their issues today, but Mitchell Trubisky throwing 59%, which is a season low for him this year. Two touchdowns, one interception. Jordan Howard, 17 carries, 123 on the ground. And of course, Paul Richardson. Who knows where the Bears would have been this game without those two big catch and runs. Could have easily been a loss for the Bears this week. Stafford throws for 319 yards, 75%, two touchdowns plus that one pick. Riddick had a couple of big runs today, but not too much to worry about. Of course, we are worried about the play of the secondary this week. Ebron had a great game. Galladay had a great game as well. Most of those yards, unfortunately, coming on that one big catch and run on their first possession. But the numbers do not lie. 3 of 12 for the Lions on third downs. Bears defense once again getting the job done when it matters. We'll move into week 5. It's the Bears and the Minnesota Vikings for the first time this season, as the Bears are one of two undefeated teams left in the NFL, the Falcons being the other. Packers off to a 1-2 start, the Lions 1-3. Of course, there's a lot of season left to go. I do want to update you guys on the numbers so far for our Bears through the first four games of the season. Trubisky playing very well, good touchdown to interception ratio. Jordan Howard is the number one rusher in the league right now, average at 109 yards per game. Richardson now leads in receptions, yards, and tied with Collins for touchdowns, as Collins didn't have a catch this game. Sacks given up this year, 4 through 4 games for Kasheem Douglas and 4 for Vollmer through 4 games. Gotta hope we clean things up, but Douglas is progressing very well. Confidence boost is helping his pass block out a little bit, which is the main concern. Adrian Amos, Mark Barron, Bennett Cooper, and EJ Gaines lead the Bears in tackles this year. Akeem Hicks with 5.5 sacks through 4 games. Wong with 4.5, which is not bad at all. Gotta hope he can keep that up and maybe wrap up Rookie of the Year. Fuller with 2 interceptions so far, the Bears with 4 overall. And pass deflections, we're doing a pretty decent job getting deflections, but we need to see more. TJ Cartwright, 7-for-8 so far this season. Longest kick of 52 yards. And Pat O'Donnell playing pretty decently. Kick coverage is not the best right now. On returns, Patterson handling most of the kick returns so far, and Cohen handling the punt returns. And here's a look at some of the other big impact rookies. First round pick, or number one overall pick, Artis Cochran. Not a bad year for him so far. And Tywan Harden. No interceptions so far, but still playing very well for the Dolphins. Of course, we will see the Dolphins in week 17. So thank you all for tuning in to this episode of the Chicago Bears franchise. Before the game against Minnesota, our first scouting update will be for the corners. And I'll see you guys then. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.